top 10 private bee schools in India.
Our focus is on cutting edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class businesses.
BinTech, excellence with values.
Academic learning is essential for more efficient learning in the non-academic world. Studying in an institution like BIMTECH enables you to better become capable of understanding different disciplines that are relevant for your working life and increases analytical abilities. But the process of learning must continue throughout your entire life. Those who keep learning are going to be the most successful people. Those who stop learning or believe that they've learned enough will, from that point onwards, cease to grow. India over the years has not developed as fast as many other countries who, not so many decades ago, were behind us. Most people will agree that in terms of resources, the future far more than ever existed in India in the past. And these will be in areas not confined only to the IT or the BPO sectors or consultancy, but in many, many other fields of activity. In making this happen, the actions of the government undoubtedly are of great importance. But I do not believe that government by itself can accelerate growth or make good things happen. This has to come from all of us understanding what our new roles are and to play them effectively. Today, I would like to talk on what I believe the role of leaders of industry and business should be if we want to make India into a preferred place for industrial and manufacturing activity. Leaders in the industrial and business world can maximize their efforts only if they fully understand the political, economic, and social culture of the country where they work and adapt policies and actions accordingly. In India, we have learned management theories and practices largely from the West. Numerous students go to Western colleges and business schools, even in our business schools. The courses and case studies are mostly derived from the Western business schools. Management practices in companies are in many ways similar to those in the West. The question is whether the management systems of the West are appropriate to our political and economic environment. The economies of the US and the UK have shown increasingly lack of competitiveness in industrial production and have moved more towards financial and service areas. We, on the other hand, want manufacturing to increase its share in GDP and create jobs for the youth. For this to happen, the competition...
We are all democracies. However, we have followed the UK pattern of governance, not the presidential system of the USA. Income levels and extent of poverty are very different in India compared to these countries. We are a country of far greater diversity in all respects, including social structure. We have not been able to achieve universal literacy, and the healthcare facilities are not as well developed as in the West. I believe all these factors are relevant to the nature of management practices that will lead to success. Leaders will only win the trust and confidence of workers and others and get their wholehearted involvement in making improvements if policies and actions of management are appropriate to our environment. In 1950, we accepted socialism as our political ideology, as it is believed that with a huge population, large changes
in that system had to be made from 1991 onwards. However, the social ideology practiced for over 40 years has resulted in a large number of intellectuals, politicians, bureaucrats, and media believing that profit making and wealth creation by individual industrialists was not in the national interest. Many of the policies framed by the central and state governments were based on this belief and are still in force. It has led to the thinking that industry can afford to pay higher prices for inputs and other areas where government and government agencies need money than other segments of the economy. A large number of laws and regulations to control industry and protect the interest of workers exist. The cost of compliance has become high and affected competitiveness without really achieving the object of either improving the condition of workers or better governance. While the central government has started to make changes and ease of doing business is now a priority policy, the states have by and large not moved as fast. There's a need for industrialists and managers to be aware of the political compulsions of the government and be sensitive to them while making their own policies and management practices. Participate in substantially contributing to continuous improvements in productivity and quality and finding ways to reduce cost. The partnership relation between workers and management in Japan is the reason why Japanese industry became so highly competitive despite the disadvantage of not having natural resources and export markets being very distant. In India, Maruti has shown that the same conditions as in Japan can be created by adopting means which may be a modification of what the Japanese did. There are, of course, many good things to learn from the West, and it would be a serious error to think that we should not look at the West at all. What is important is that Western, or for that matter, Eastern practices and experience should not be blindly copied in India without a careful examination to judge what could successfully work in the Indian environment, though with some modifications. Managers and leaders in India have also appreciated the obvious fact that any law, rule, regulation or practice is only as good as its implementation. It makes it important to understand what can be implemented and how. And as you know, implementation depends on people, and then to understand what people will do and why depends on understanding their motivations, the social and economic conditions. We should not accept alibis. Instead, a root cause analysis should be done to identify the real causes of any failure, use the failure as a learning process, change what needs to be changed to ensure better performance in the future. This has to be an ongoing exercise. Unfortunately, in India, we generally tend to look for alibis for failure, not to look for lessons on how to use those failures to make improvements. And that is why we have not been very good implementers. Everybody says that Indians are excellent policy makers, excellent talkers and debaters, very poor implementers. All of you are potential leaders of tomorrow. You have a responsibility, those who have not been as fortunate as you, to get education in a top institution. When you start your careers, think how your organization can continue to grow bigger and more competitive, how you can contribute to that. Your personal careers and your quality of life will automatically take care of itself if the institution where you work continues to grow in competitiveness and size. There will be no need to plan your career moves, spend a great deal of time and energy in working out where you plan to be every 5 years or so. Thank you very much for this patient listening and wishing you a very, very successful future.